performance report, which is also being placed in the public domain on their website. Now, we who represent our constituent, if we look through the report, we want to know, you know, how is the budget performing? Now, one of the things people don't understand is that I represent River G County, I also represent Liberia, and two, I represent a constituent of individuals who look for the economics in any report. Okay, that's also my constituent. Okay, I represent an intellectual base. I want to know, I want to see us discussing the issue. So when we reach to that point, there's no need for an executive. When we are discussing and there's a need for an executive, that will be noted. And even the public will know. So I thought it was not important. I didn't come this morning prepared. I just saw I have my 360 laptop. This laptop is like an iPad, okay? I have my information in it. I don't have to take big book in the session. It brought for us a report. And have other reports here that I've been linking. So prepare for us to ask a question. For example, the fiscal year 18-19 consolidated report, okay, which is broken down into this quarterly report, okay, that 18-19 report, this one is for the 19-20 performance. Mm-hmm. Now, that 18-19 report shows for each line, ministry, and agency the amount that was expended for the period, the actual amount, okay. Now, I just ran a test in a local PPCC. PPCC sent in the report, I just received it this morning. And I ran a test of PPCC report, linking it with the Ministry of Finance report. There is a variant of what they say they got from the Ministry of Finance, a variant of more than 150,000. So it tells you that there was a need for us to look at the report. It's not going to tell somebody that you have stolen. What is the speaker protecting? You cannot protect the Ministry of Finance. Ministry of Finance is a lying person. Okay, he's our colleague, we worked together before. We trust his ability. That's why he should come to us for a discuss the issue. What the speaker fear? This same speaker who was raising his concern about accountability over time, now he want to be opaque? Because it's not even transparency anymore. Because if you have to go to session on discuss the financial budgeting matter, then I think you're not transparent. Transparency doesn't mean that, oh, this may have stolen. And they don't say that, let the people see. Let it come for something.
Now that the finance minister and you know some deputies have appeared in the executive, you have worked all of that, you know, agendas acting, and you member of the Waste Means Committee, and also your expertise in financial matters requires. So, what would the public say?
What good is my expertise behind the scene? How good is it? Because executive with me, whatever I discuss is not meant for the public. So what good is that? Did you send me for that? I mean, if I go to executive, it must be some serious national security issue, or maybe issue that is so peculiar to the legislature that the public should now get for the first instance, then that's it. But if you say, when the agenda item say budget performance for the country, so I go there. My expertise is not needed in a secret session, okay? Is needed in an open area where I can be challenged. Because I want to say things and do things that people see. I didn't intend for that. And I think the minister was waiting for that because, I mean, the first time we said we were moving from executive again, we said open session. Today, we saw executive and we raised our unreadiness. And you see how it was being played. You saw the movement of the speaker. So just that indeed, he's the one that demanded for the executive.
You know what is happening?
I think he's trying to protect a brain child, out of frustration. That's what I think.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.